Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello. We are going to be reacting to Arch Enemy's Eye of the Storm. Okay, so far we've got very ocean currents. It looks like a castle in the background. That looks like a stadium version of a Camelot castle. So far there, I think that was Michael Amott, the main guitarist. The one that's always in interviews with Alyssa anyway. And that looks like it could be Alyssa in this red glowing squid. As far as her skin, it's like she's got some sort of like patternized mud patches on her. I will run till I die under these black skies. Tyrannic law, a razor claw in the eye of the storm. Well, that circular storm moment there reminded me so much of War of the Worlds, Tom Cruise movie. Trying to figure out what this guy's purpose is with the undeveloped skull, jaw, mouth piece thing. And they're all a bit muddy as well. Like war paint muddy. He's got something glowing, but like I said, they're looking very occulty, priesty, apostle-y. Take your pick. Hello, we're red stormed. Now we're looking very supernova. I figured a skull faced dude that was rising up. So with all that being said, it was very music wise actually quite chill considering Arch Enemy's usual elements of power. Vocals, obviously Alyssa just kills it, no doubt about that, no surprise there. I love how that there was like more grey cool tone storm shades and then just slightly more red and then very supernova, like the sun exploded but it turned into plasmic and very supernatural type of effect, especially with all that like a bit of a sparkle. It sounds odd to say, but Marilyn Monroe's very sparkly red dress that she once wore, it was very sparkly like that, sequiny, that's what I was looking for. When the sun or whatever it was turned, I think it was more like the beginning of that storm, like the War of the Worlds type storm. With that, it's like it evolved to something else, and then as it filtered everything, it just looked very red and sequiny to best describe it. Again, music wise, as much as the music for electric and rock and the riffs was very laid back, Alyssa's vocals were very almost talkative. Like talking type screaming obviously. Visual effects, obviously a lot of CGI would have been used, including green screen and a film set, but it's very storm outlike and very post-apocalyptic or futuristic more specifically, especially with that transparent cube, the red rounded thing. It's very one environment based, exactly like their previous song and music video House, I believe it was House of Mirrors, where they were looking like they were in a like Alice Madness castle environments, and the way the camera was motioning around was very an all new level of a game was loading, and it just sets the environment for you, for the player. That's just what that looked like. For this, it was, I believe Alyssa was like in two different outfits, a black light tank top, hence why I've got a spike like tank top on, and her white singlet top. They all had like little mud patches on their skin. They're just the end result of being caught up in a wicked storm. mud and water type storm. A lot of stormy like visual effects. It's very 2012 as far as all those stormy themes. Obviously, Eye of the Storm was also technically very metaphorical. In the Eye of a Lot of Trouble, in the Eye of a Lot of Distress. I don't really get what the purpose of the disciple dudes in the cloaks were all about, or with the developing skull jaw face mask. Yeah, clearly they were achieving something supernatural and supernova related towards the end, like halfway through the video, but towards the end especially. I mean, I'm sure if anybody else has a proper explanation for, you know, the supernova effect of it, please let me know, because I'm clearly stumped for ideas. But otherwise, the whole music video was just superb. Vocals were so good, very spaced out and almost poetic. Like, especially when you take your time phrasing each chapter of a long-listed poem. The song was lyric wise and the positioning of the lyrics. Just the paraphrase of the lyrics was very, like reciting a very long-listed poem or scripts or scripture, if you will. So, and there was also some more relaxed vocals of Alyssa, especially the towards the end song bridge. I don't know what I'm talking about, but you know what I mean. So this was my reaction to Arch Enemies in the Eye of the Storm. This week is itchy. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do hope you enjoyed, and I shall see you all for my future videos. Adios.